एवरीवन, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग एंड जय हिंद एवरीवन। चिल्ड्रन, आई वंस अगेन वेलकम यू टू ऑल इन माय इंग्लिश क्लास। चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द लास्ट टॉपिक दैट इज रिमेनिंग फॉर आवर एनुअल कोर्स, फॉर आवर एनुअल टर्म, राइट चिल्ड्रन? सो आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज द लास्ट parts of speech, that is interjection. Children, as you all know that there are 8 parts of speech, right? And you have been learning it throughout the year in class 3 as well as in class 2 also you have read about them. They are nouns, pronouns, adjectives, verb, adverb, conjunction, preposition, right? And today we are going to know about the last one, that is interjections, right? Now children, see, what are interjections? Oh, wow, yummy, alas, bravo, hooray. So you might be laughing at me, children, right now, that what ma'am is doing. Well children, there is a reason to do this way, to behave this way. Because children, the words that I just said few seconds back, they are nothing but they are interjections. Yes, exactly, they are interjections, nothing else. So what are interjections? Sudden feeling that outbursts either because of happiness or because of sorrow, that is called as interjection. Yes, so we are going to know about interjections, and at the same time we will, after completing this topic, we will also do one more topic, that is words, that is there in your English grammar book. So in words we are going to do few exercises, that is exercise 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, right? So first let's start with interjection, then we are going to jump to words. So let's start it, and let me just share my screen. So please look carefully. Whatever I show you, just listen and see the things. Okay, so what are interjections? As I told you, can you just read that out in front of screen that you can see? Interjections are nothing but what are they? They are there to express some sudden feeling, right? They just expresses sudden feeling of happiness or of sorrow. When we want to appreciate someone, we want to give greetings to someone, or we share the joy or sadness, then we express such feelings with some words, and these words are called interjections. So let us now see some examples, children. Like right now in front of your screen you can see the first example, that is hooray, we won the match. So can you see, children, the word hooray, this particular term is used to show the feeling of excitement, of happiness. When we win something, when we are awarded something, then we say the term hooray. So hooray is nothing but is a term to express a sudden feeling of happiness, right children? Now let's see one more example. Wow, when we use this word, may we have been using such words then and there, like when we say wow, what a nice dress, or we say that somebody has done made a beautiful drawing or painted something nice, then to appreciate someone we say wow, what a nice drawing, or what a nice dress you are wearing. So wow shows a sudden expression of surprise or of excitement, right? Now see the third example. Alas, the fish is dead. So in this case, children, you will see that we also share the feeling of sadness. When we are sad, then also we can express our feelings showing by how हाँ वे यूजिंग सच इंटरजेक्शन वर्ड्स लाइक अलास और ओह और समथिंग लाइक नो नॉट नो 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 कैन नॉट हैपन अलास ओ नो सो सच वर्ड्स आर फीलिंग ऑफ एक्सप्रेशंस ऑफ सॉरो राइट नाउ चिल्ड्रन यू विल सी दैट इन एवरी वर्ड वेदर इट्स हुर्रे और इट्स वाओ और अलास और ऑसम वी एवरी टाइम आफ्टर यूजिंग दीज इंटरजेक्शन वर्ड्स वी पुट एन एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क व्हाट इज एन एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क चिल्ड्रन वी यू विल एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क इज मेड लाइक विद अ स्ट्रेट लाइन and then a dot below it, right? So what is this? It is called as an exclamation mark. So always children, remember this. Dhyan rakhenge ki interjection words ko use karne ke baad, always it will be followed by an exclamation mark. Whenever you are using interjection words, you have to, after that, you have to add the exclamation mark to what this exclamation mark shows. This shows a sudden feeling of excitement or sorrow. Now let me just show you some more such words, interjection words like yuck, yuck, ouch, ouch when we say when we get hurt, yup when we agree to someone, oh when we are surprised, hey to pay attention, to get somebody's attention, we say hey how are you, oh again, so oh means oh I was not knowing about it, oh that happened, aha, okay, so when we are happy to know about it, we say aha, okay, like that. Oh no, we say when we are not feeling happy about something, we say shh. When do we say shh? When we want everybody to be quiet, when there should be a pin drop silence, we say shh, right? So such words are used to show our expression, sudden expression of joy or happiness, right children? So let us now know more about interjections from your book. So please now open page number 82 of your book, lesson number 21, and let's read out what's there in your book. Okay, so read the following sentences. Hooray, we won the match. Alas, the poor dog is dead. Bravo, well hit. Ouch, you have stepped on my foot. The word hooray expresses joy. What does hooray express? Hooray expresses a sudden feeling of joy, right? Alas, this word expresses grief, right? When something wrong happens, a grief, out of sorrow, we say alas. Bravo expresses admiration. When we admire someone, when we appreciate them for their special work, for their special job, then we say bravo, bravo, it was a nice shot, right? Like this. Ouch is expressed to show sudden pain. When we feel pain, all of a sudden we say ouch, right? So words which express joy, grief, or such sudden or strong feelings are called interjections. So these sentences are also called exclamatory sentences. Why, children, this is called as exclamatory sentence? Because we put an exclamation mark after them. As I told you, that after every interjection words, we will definitely, without fail, we will put an exclamation mark. So that's why they are also called as exclamatory sentences. Now, let's do this exercise quickly, children. Fill in the blanks with interjection words. So, dash, I walk quietly. Main dheere se chalta hoon. So, which is the appropriate one? Hooray, I walk quietly. Shh, I walk quietly. Ugh, I walk quietly. Or ouch, I walk quietly. I will say, shh, walk quietly. धीरे से चलो, राइट। नंबर बी, डैश, आई हैव बर्न्ड माय हैंड ऑन द केटल। ओह आउच, मेरा हाथ केटल से बर्न हो गया। सो देन वी से आउच व्हेन वी फील सडन पेन। डैश, इंडिया हैज वन व्हेन वी आर सो एक्साइटेड दैट समबडी हैज वन। सो व्हाट वी विल से, हुर्रे इंडिया हैज वन। नेक्स्ट, हाउ कैन यू ईट दैट हॉरिबल स्टफ। आग, कैसे वो तुम गंदी सी चीज खा सकते हो, हॉरिबल, राइट। सो देन वी से आग, राइट। सो दिस इज हाउ वी यूज दीज इंटरजेक्शन वर्ड्स टू एक्सप्रेस द फीलिंग्स ऑफ हैप्पीनेस और जॉय दैट कम्स सडनली और दैट इज एक्सप्रेस्ड सडनली, राइट चिल्ड्रेन। इज दैट क्लियर टू एवरीवन? होप सो चिल्ड्रेन। नाउ वी आर मूविंग फर्दर चिल्ड्रेन, वी विल नाउ do lesson number 24, that is words. So in this chapter children, we are going to do exercise number 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Please refer page number 104 to 107. Okay, so please first open one page number 104, right. So here in page number 104, we are first going to know about synonyms. Children, you already know about synonyms. In unit test 2 also, you had synonyms as well as antonyms, right? So, what are synonyms? I will just quickly repeat it. Words that are similar in meaning. Okay, they have similar meanings, like the word meanings that you do. So, the words which have similar meaning, they are called as synonyms. Example, small can be synonym for little. Big can be a synonym for large. So large and big both are same thing. Small or little are again small, same thing, right? So now let's do this exercise. Exercise number 5. Choose the correct synonym from the brackets. The sum is so hard. So what would be the correct synonym for hard? Easy or difficult? Difficult, certainly. So just circle the word difficult. This toy bear is so fluffy. So fluffy means hard or soft? Soft, right. Can you make a mask for me? So make, synonym of make can be destroy or create. To create something, right. We waited for me till the end. End means first or last, means till last, right. I like you very much. So like means I love you very much or I dislike you very much. I love you, right? Do you own a guitar? Own means to have something, to possess something. So do you have a guitar or do you own a guitar? Right? It's just one and the same. Now let's do the next exercise. Write two synonyms for the words given below. One has been done for you. Children, you can do this on your own, though I am just giving you some examples, but there can be more examples apart from the words that I have given. Like the synonym of beautiful can be either pretty or attractive. Both are almost all giving the same meaning of beautiful, right? Beautiful will be attractive as well as pretty. So cool can be either cold or it can also be called as chilly. It is a chilly day, it's cold or it's cool outside. So it's just the same, right? Dark can be synonymed as unlit or dull, right? End can be synonymed as finish or complete. Fast can be synonymed as swift or quick, right? Great can be synonymed as exceptional or special, right? But children, again I'm repeating, these are just few examples. Don't think that only these are the words which can be the synonym of the words that are given here, okay? So if you find it in the dictionary, you will get more such synonyms word apart from the words that I've given. I have chosen the most known words that we generally speak. So I've chosen few of them. If you know some other words that are similar to this word given there, you can write that too, right? Now let's know about antonyms. So what are antonyms? Antonyms are nothing but just the opposite words, okay? Look at the pictures alongside. These are antonyms, opposites. Antonyms are words opposite in meaning to another. Example, हॉट एंड कोल्ड. सो हॉट का ऑपोजिट हो गया कोल्ड. बिग एंड स्मॉल, बिग एंड उसका ऑपोजिट हो गया छोटा स्मॉल. फास्ट एंड स्लो. सो द वर्ड्स दैट आर ऑपोजिट इन मीनिंग आर कॉल्ड एज एंटोनिम्स, राइट. सो लेट्स सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज नंबर 7. मैच द फॉलोइंग वर्ड्स विद देयर एंटोनिम्स. लॉस्ट, found, neat, dirty, rude, polite, start, stop, early, late, heavy, light, tall, short, ugly, beautiful, right? So these are the antonyms word. Now let's know about homophones. What are homophones, children? Read the following sentences. I cannot hear you. I wish you were here. So can you see, children, the words hear and here, both when we sound them, when we speak them up, both sound similar, right? But then their meaning, their spellings are different. The first one is H-E-A-R and the second one is H-E-R-E. Not only their spellings are different, but then their meanings are different too, right, children? Like, see, the words here, H-E-A-R and H-E-R-E, sound the same, but their meanings and spellings are completely different. They are called homophones. So H-E-A-R here means sunna. Do you hear something? हम बोलते हैं ना, क्या तुमने कुछ सुना? डू यू हियर समथिंग? एंड एच ई आर ई हियर मीन्स यहाँ, कम हियर, राइट, यहाँ आओ, राइट. सो बोथ हैव टू डिफरेंट मीनिंग्स. नाउ हियर इज अ लिस्ट ऑफ सम मोर सच वर्ड्स लाइक पी ए आई आर, पैर. पैर मीन्स जोड़ी, जुड़वा. एंड पी ए आर, पियर, इज अ फ्रूट, राइट. डब्ल्यू ओ एन, वन. One means jeetna, win ka past tense one. And one, one means ek. S-E-E-C means dekhna. And S-E-A-C means samudra, right? Samandar. B-E-A-R, bear. So bear means bhalu. B-E-A-R, bear means bhalu. And B-A-R-E, bear means without anything. Theek hai? Without, bare feet, right? A-N-T, aunt. Aunt means cheeti. And A-U-N-T, aunt, means auntie, है ना? हम maternal aunt, चाची या मौसी को, बुआ को हम aunt कहते हैं, right? H-A-I-R, hair, means बाल. And H-A-R-E, hair, means जंगली जो rabbits होते हैं, उन्हें हम hair कहते हैं, right? So, now, let's do exercise number 8 from page number 106. Match the words with the pictures. P-R-E-Y, prey. So, P-R-E-Y, prey means, shikar. So, who's preying someone, an animal? The tiger is preying the deer. So, this one, prey. P-R-E-Y, prey. And P-R-A-Y, prey means prathna karna. So, this one, this picture is the correct match for P-R-A-Y, prey. T-H-R-E-Y. W, threw, fakena. T-H-R-E-W, threw means fakena. So this one, see this picture. And T-H-R-O-U-G-H, through means uske through, us taraf se. Like I went through the jungle. Maine us taraf se cross kiya jungle. Jungle ke through, jungle ke raaste se main gaya. So T-H-R-O-U-G-H, through. T-A-L-E, tail means T-A-L-E, tail means kahani. T-A-L-E, tail means kahani. And T-A-I-L, tail means poonch. Right? M-E-E-T, meet means milna. Right? And M-E-A-T, meet means mans. Right? Now, exercise number 9. Complete the following sentences with the help of the homophones given in the brackets. A dash had stung Mary. So, B-E-E-B या B-E-B. B-E-E-B. एक मधुमक्खी ने मैरी को स्टंग कर लिया. I will dash very happy if you help me. I will be. मैं बहुत खुश होऊंगा. Faisal dash where the phone was. Faisal नहीं जानता था. So, K-N-E-W-N-E-W या N-E-W-N-E-W. K KNEW नहीं जानता था. गौरव बॉट अ डैश शर्ट यस्टरडे, न्यू शर्ट, NEW नया, राइट. द स्काई इज BLEW और BLUE ब्लू, नीला कलर. मदर डैश आउट द कैंडल्स, मदर ने ब्लू कर दिया कैंडल्स, ब्लो करना, ब्लो का पास्ट टेंस ब्लू, फूंक देना, राइट. नाउ नेक्स्ट वन, इट इज डैश ओ क्लॉक नाउ, सो EIGHT 8 o'clock, 8 बज गए. वी डैश अ हर्टी मील, वी एट अ हर्टी मील, एट, ईट का पास्ट टेंस एट, ATE 8 मीन्स खाया था. ही डैश हिज बाइक टू ऑफिस, सो ही RODE रोड हिज बाइक टू ऑफिस, राइड का पास्ट टेंस रोड, राइड किया था उसने अपना बाइक ऑफिस लेकर गया था. द डैश वॉज डग फॉर रिपेयर्स, द रोड वॉज ROAD, रोड वॉज डग फॉर रिपेयर्स, रोड मीन्स ROAD, रोड मीन्स रास्ता. नंबर F, डैश मी अ लेटर, सो राइट, WRITE, राइट मी अ लेटर. डू वॉट इज RIGHT, राइट, वो करो जो सही है, राइट, RIGHT मीन्स सही. आई कैन डैश अ लाइट फार अवे, आई कैन सी, देख सकता हूँ मैं, SEE अ लाइट फार अवे. एंड द डैश वॉज डीप एंड डार्क, द सी वॉज डीप एंड डार्क, SEA. ही विल गो डैश शॉर्टली, वो वहाँ थोड़ी देर में जाएगा, सो ही विल गो देयर, THERE. आप यहाँ पर बहुत कंफ्यूज होते हैं बेटा, यहाँ ही आप बहुत मिस्टेक करते हैं. THERE देयर मीन्स वहाँ, एंड THEIR देयर मीन्स उनका, THEIR देयर मीन्स उनका. आई एम डैश आंट, मैं उनका, आई एम देयर आंट, राइट, मैं उनकी आंट हूँ, उन बच्चों की आंट हूँ, राइट. सो नाउ एक्सरसाइज 10 चिल्ड्रन, दो इट्स नॉट देयर इन योर सिलेबस, बट स्टिल आई वॉन्ट यू टू डू दिस एज अ होमवर्क, बिकॉज दिस विल हेल्प यू टू लर्न द स्पेलिंग्स वेल, टू अंडरस्टैंड द स्पेलिंग वेल, एंड टू प्रैक्टिस इट. सो हाउ यू हैव टू डू दिस, सॉल्व दिस, आइडेंटिफाई एंड टेक द करेक्ट स्पेलिंग ऑफ द गिवन वर्ड. सो यू हैव टू जस्ट टिक ऑन द correct spelling, right, like the spelling of birthday. So there are 3 different spellings given, whichever is correct you have to take it, like birthday, birthday, or budday. So the correct one is this one, right. So this is how you are going to solve all of them from till A to H, right children. So this is your homework for today, and keep on practicing such more exercises children. So here our course for unit test gets over, right. Now from next class we will start the revision for our annual exam, and I will start conducting tests. So children, just prepare yourself thoroughly. I will ask you whenever I'm conducting the Zoom classes, I will ask you all the questions, that how well you are learning, I will get to know. So please prepare yourself very well for your exam, because now not much time is left in your hand, very short time is left children, so please start preparing. So this much is more than enough for today. We are going to meet again in our next class. Till then, take care and have a great day.